reminding them by neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor,
I'm glad to sit on the part of you. Now just hug somebody, shake somebody's hand, tell them it's good to see you on Sunday night.
Last word being wheel, W-E-E-L.
consider other things that you have heard in time past, such as sleeping at the wheel. We don't want to preach on sleeping at the wheel, but now that will preach. That will preach. Physically, you can sleep at the wheel, and Brother Davis, they tell me when you go to sleep at the wheel, good things don't happen generally at the end of your transportation of journey. So don't go to sleep. Whatever you do, look to your neighbor and say, don't ever go to sleep at the wheel. Amen. Praise God. Now, I don't want to take a poll, but who's ever been guilty of falling asleep at the wheel? Amen. And I see I'm not the only one that got a reason to praise his name. Fell asleep at the wheel, you look up, and you're at your house. Has that ever happened to anyone outside of myself? And I know I've been asleep a few times. I didn't know how I got the way I needed to be, Brother Davis. Well, actually, I do know how. I actually do know how. I know I didn't do it. And I just reasoned within myself that it must have been the Lord. Must have been the Lord. So I give him all praise and the glory. And when you have situations such as that, you ought to praise the Lord differently. You ever been in a life or death situation? I've been in situations where I could have been wrong. One time in particular, I know these guys were up to no good. And I was at the gas station, broad daylight. Gas station, I'm traveling out of state, didn't know where I was. These two brothers, amen, came up and looking all into the car. I'm inside. I just have to look out there and be circling with me, you know. And I said to myself, well, I'll say. And I said some other things too, but I said, well, I'll say. I said, well, I'll say. But God got me out of that mess unscathed. And they could have jumped me. And I thought they were getting ready to try. Because you know me, I just believe in bearing the arms. Amen, somebody. But God got me out of it, nonetheless. Sitting on the potter's wheel. Now, this is a most interesting text because here we have God who is at work. He's about to do something wonderful in the lives of his people. He has his manservant, his prophet Jeremiah, go down to the potter's house. And he shows Jeremiah a case of his grace, whereby God is going to do something for his people that they really don't deserve. God is about to deliver them from circumstances beyond their control. And in order to give a portrait of God moving in the lives of his people, he sends his prophet down to the potter's house. Now, not down to Dallas. I'm talking about the potter's house in the scripture. He sends him down to the potter's house. And when Jeremiah gets to the potter's house, he learns some valuable lessons of how God works with his people. I take the position that anybody who is a child of God has to first of all understand that they are sitting on the potter's wheel. They are sitting on the what sits on the wheel. And finally, I want to look at the patience of the individual who was sitting on the potter's wheel. Now, I want to get Isaiah 64 and verse number 8. Hold what you have here. But Isaiah 64 and verse number 8. Because God has a plan, a purpose, and he has us to go through an experience of patience in order to produce the final product. Now, in Isaiah 64, verse number 8, the Bible, the Word of God says what?
But now, O Lord.
Now, O Lord.
Thou art our Father.
Now, watch it. You are our Father.
We are the clay.
Now, we are the clay.
And thou art the potter.
And you are the potter.
And we.
Now, you are our Father. We are the clay. And you, O Lord, are the potter. So therefore, Isaiah unlocks for us who the person is at the wheel. Now, the person at the wheel is God our Father. He is the one who is fashioning the clay. We are the clay. We are his people. We are the clay. We are sitting on the potter's wheel. If I were to ask you a question, who is the person who makes the potter, or who is the potter, you would say it's God our Father. God our Father is the potter. God our Father is the person. And God our Father secondly has the power. Now, to say that he has the power, it means that the power is not in the clay, but the power is in the potter. Are you getting this? I say everyone who's sitting at the wheel, you don't have any power to produce and make yourself what you ought to be. You are totally dependent upon the power of the Father, who is the person, God our Father. All of us are sitting on the instrumentation of the wheel of the Father, but nobody who is clay has power within himself. We don't have the power to make ourselves what we ought to be. We are all totally dependent upon the power of the potter. And the potter is the person of God our Father, God himself. He is the potter, and everyone who's on the wheel is the clay. But now, I want you to know, my friends, that God has a plan. God has a plan. Each piece of clay that sits on the potter's wheel, the potter has a plan for the clay. Now, the power of the plan is not in the clay, but it's in the mind of the potter. But the only way the plan of the potter can be seen is that the clay has to remain on the wheel so that the power might be unleashed. Here it is. All of us are clay. All of us sit on the potter's wheel. God has power unspeakable. But God has a plan for all of the clay that sits on the wheel. And the only way you can understand what the plan is that the clay has to stay Whatever the plan is that God has, is the best plan for you to have. I said, whatever the plan is, whatever his plan is for me, is the best plan for me. And the only way that I'm going to be a finished product is I have to stay on the wheel. And I like the fact that God has a plan. God has a plan. But I also enjoy the reality that in order for God's plan to be made manifest, I've got to maintain patience while sitting on the wheel. God has the finished product in his mind. I don't know what God knows. I don't know what God will do with me. But what I do know is that whatever he does decide to do, it's ultimately the best plan for me to have. But the only way that I'm going to be blessed in the plan, I have to stay on the wheel. God has a finished picture in his mind. The clay cannot finish himself, but the potter finishes the clay. The clay, watch it, it's lumpy, it's bumpy, it is rough, it is undeveloped. It is unfinished while it sits on the wheel. But through the process of molding and sculpting and shaping, God is fashioning what I'm supposed to look like at the end. Don't judge me for what I look like right now.
Somebody has said, I'm no use. Yeah.
to stay home. And if I tell the truth about it, sometimes when you're on the wheel, the potter, the person who has the plan and has the power, sometimes he has to beat. He has to beat on the clay. Sometimes he has to.
Sunday night,
because we recognize that we just sit on the weak. I need as much church in me and as much Jesus in me. Every time the doors of the church swing open, I need to be here because I am still sitting on that wheel. Don't trip over me because I look unloved. I'm still sitting on the wheel. One day, he'll have what he wants to be. You hear him tonight? You need to say yes to King Jesus. You need to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. You're willing to repent of all of your sins and confess his name before him. Go down to the watery grave of baptism for the remission of your sins. When you're covered in the water, you meet the blood of the Lamb. It's the precious blood of the Lamb. It's an innocent blood. It will hide you from the judgment that is to come. As long as you stay on the wheel. Now, part of the body of Christ, you need to get in. You need to get in the body. You need to be baptized once a time. If you are part of the body and you need to rededicate yourself, do it right now while the blood pumps in your veins. Because one day, time will be no more. Will you come as a fellow singer the song of invitation?
I don't wait, Lord.
Watch me out of the water.